Welcome, mates, I'm Bloodthirsty Lore, but you can call me Lordy, and today we're playing as the new hero, Khaimera, within Paragon, and he is the Master Jungler, and that's what we're going to play today in the jungle role, Khaimera. So this will be very interesting. We're going to go with the starter deck, which is the fighter deck. The minions have already spawned, so we better get into an offlane just for quite a bit, so we can get some XP, and that should be kind of great for us. We need to go to an offlane that has only two people, including me. I might go to the left-hand side, I'm thinking about it. Ooh, shell, see, or even mid lane, it's all cool. Either way, we'll be getting XP. That's what we want. Yeah, that deck skin looks pretty nice. I think it was the energized one, I'm not sure though. So we're gonna put a point into our unleash ability, which is our primary ability, and we will explain that very soon. So right now we're going to the mid wave, or the mid lane, and getting some XP out of that. Or the right off lane, one or the other. I'm hoping we can get the lane just for a bit. Yeah, it looks like we can. There's only two players here, that'll be great. That's a Master Grux skin, boys. We need to give some respect to him, just in case. Oh my god, this character, the way he swings. So beast-like. Yes, we have. Yes, boys! We got an early game kill already! Me and Gideon just went ham there. Playing in a five-man party, and these guys are amazing goal-like players. That's one thing I know for sure. As you can see, we just demolished them then, so that is pretty good for us. I'm gonna go to the off lane, just get some XP from this right lane, and then we go back into our jungle. If we can get a kill, this will be pretty amazing. The enemy Khaimera was there, but we just completely neglected him and his existence. Let's get this cleared. There we go. Now we're level 2, now we can go back into the jungle and start clearing these white camps, and then get a buff camp very soon. We're going to put a point into our spirit regeneration. We'll explain this kit very soon. I just want to try to keep my eyes on the minimap, so we know what the enemy team is trying to do, and then we can most likely respond to it, and hopefully leads to a certain win, like a counter gank, or something that happens. I'm just watching the map though. So that's the most interesting part of the whole game, just map awareness. We can't do this level 2 yet. Nah, it'd be too hard. They're playing it safe though. Our team is pushing on the left hand side, so that's good. But the enemy team is not reacting yet. I expect them to react very soon. I'm hoping my team places wards just around the actual shadow pads and sections, because that'll be very useful. Can we kill this guy? We've got our ambush as well. Let's do that. Let's go in. Let's go in ham, boys. Come on, come on. We're so close. There we go. Our first kill as Khaimera. This is pretty much our first look gameplay on my second time trying out, since the first game didn't go too well. The lag was just too unbearable, and we had a little problem just occurring here and there, but that does not matter. This is the gameplay that does matter, since we're going to be going ham in this gameplay. We're level 3. We're going to try and clear this recap. I want to see how good he is with his spirit regeneration stacks, and how much health regen we can get, and if we can actually clear camp at level 3, a buff camp. Hoping we can. We can't use the ambush ability on these minions or monsters, because it just doesn't work out. It only works on actual certain enemy heroes, or just enemy heroes in general. Come on, can we do this? Should be able to do this, come on. Don't cheat me, boys! Let me get it! There we go. Now I'm terrified. There we go. Hopefully no one comes and kills us. We're looking pretty good at this very moment, and that is very good for us. So we're going to put a point into our Q ability once again. We're going to spend some points as well, and that will be getting the wind cover blade. And we get some attack speed and damage on that, so why not? First upgrade will be major kinetic on that item, since attack speed is something that is amazing on this character, since that will help you stack your spirit and regeneration stacks. And we're going to explain his primary ability right now, since we have some time. So Unleash is his primary ability, or the Q key ability. Upon activation, attack speed is maxed out for the next 5 attacks within 5 seconds. Physical damage curtailing is reduced to 30% during these attacks, increasing each time the ability is leveled up. So that is pretty interesting. We'll explain the rest very soon. Right now we're putting a key into our well for our half star to come up in our jungle on the left hand side, so that is pretty good for us. We should have done on the right hand side as well when we were recalling, but completely neglected it then. That's all cool. Right now, we're going to try to get this blue camp before we go try and help out lanes. Most likely, we can actually get a level 5 from this, which will help us with actual ganking. And this ultimate is kind of hard to land, in my opinion. Because I think it takes some time. It's got like a channel time. And you have to stand, obviously, in the same position you're channeling it. And it becomes really hard. We see some of the enemy team try and migrate to the left-hand side. And we're going to just abuse him for that. There we go. We got him. Got him. He's gone. There's no way out of this. Come on, come on. Did we just canceled his dash ability. That was amazing, with our ambush. Since our ambush does give us a little stun, or brief stun, as it says in the description of the ability, and you will be reading that very soon. But right now, we need to get this little minion. I can't reach it. Oh my god, there we go. If you hear button mashing, that is not me, man. 100% not me. Man, I just feel like pressing constant buttons. Even if one of the buttons I can't actually press, which is the secondary ability. Right now, we're going to recall here and just get some items and also talk about some other parts within his kit. So, let's go buy something from the shop. Obviously, be a strike upgrade within our Windcarver Blade, which is a card in our deck. So, another ability on this guy is Spirit Regeneration, which is his secondary ability or his EQ ability if you're playing on PC. So, his passive for that is Chimera's Health Regen is boosted for 5 seconds each time he lands a hack attack on an enemy. And this is temporary. It doesn't stay there for the whole time, which is unfortunate. But it is very OP. If you can get that Q ability, which is your Unleash, on an enemy, you can just stack it straight away, followed up by your attack speed and pretty much your damage output, ends up being quite crazy and bloody insane. And right now, we're showing off the Master Jungler as best as possible. And hoping, I think I might go towards this right lane. My Dekka player needs some help. Gonna put another point into our Unleash ability. Unfortunately, all the stats aren't there, so I don't know what it's actually doing. I'm just hoping it increases the duration or the attack speed. He's gone. No way out of this, man. No way out of this. He thinks he's going to get out. He thinks he's going to get out, but no. Okay, maybe he will. No, he won't. No, he won't. Come on, come on. Get him. Get him. He's gone, man. There's no way. There we go. Good work, team. I love how they're still just coming out of nowhere and just destroyed him. That is amazing. And obviously this character, the way he moves, the way he plays, everything about it is so clean. Even this basic skin, I'm not in favor of the majority of the base skins they create. I always love the other skins they create. Obviously that's how it usually works with any game. But this skin looks pretty mint. It's got this white and red color scheme, plus these blue eyes that you can see, or the blue beasts coming out. And it's pretty insane. Let's get back into our jungle. Can we clear something else before going to a mid lane? No, most likely we won't go mid. We won't go mid. There's no point. Let's clear this white camp. We also get level 7 out of it, so we're going to put another point into our pounce ability or ambush. And we'll explain that very soon, what the actual stats pull that and what actually happens when I do that. But you most likely have seen a couple times already. But I'll still explain it when we have the time to. Because right now I'm going to migrate or move to the left-hand side of the map, which is the offlane, since I see the enemy Grux there, and also the steel player does, and we can do some damage on this guy. And we can also cancel his dash ability with our ambush. Why do I feel like he knows we're here? He so knows we're here. That's all cool. He's double checking. It's too late. We're gonna go try and steal some of their buffs. That's already been taken. Can't do so. So we're gonna clear this white camp. And we obviously have the enemy players chasing us. Well, this is great. This is so great. No, this is... Oh, my God. Pounce. There's too many players. There's too many players. Defend me. Oh, my God. I got caught. That was all me. That was all my fault. Honestly, the steel player came to help as well. And also the Gideon. But that was all my fault. Sorry, boys. I got caught and became a channel reaction. Oh my god, guys. I thought we could abuse him since the Grux player was pretty much still on the left-hand side, but then when I noticed he disappeared, I 100% felt like he was coming after me. Oh my god, guys. So sad. It's all cool, man. We're going to explain his other ability, and that is his ultimate ability, the Cole, or Cole. Ruidan causes 234 damage, physical damage, to enemy hero. Nearby enemies are displaced and receive a 60% max movement speed slow for 3 seconds. His melee attacks or basic attacks are called hack. Pretty much does 65 physical damage. Does 90 later on when I scale it, but it's all cool with abilities and cards that I use. Obviously, the damage increase on my hack ability. Would have been good, but yeah, if they, 100%. Let's get this red buff. I'll just read in the chat then. So cool. Let's get this red buff, boys. There's a fight going on the left-hand side. Our team should be able to win that. There's still a player got one kill. Who else is on the left-hand side? It might be Twin Blast as well. But Twin Blast is dead now. Dang. Might have died there. So cool. Why camp it? Let's do that. I'm thinking of pushing off the right off lane, since there's no one there. And it's like, why not? Since we need structures so we can end up pushing other lanes. Because that's how it ends up working in every MOBA. If you're not able to push structures, then what's the point of fighting? Because the only point you fight for is so you're able to punish the enemy team right after it. But right now, we're going to punch them since there's no one on the right-hand side. We're going to take it. It looks like the enemy player did appear, and that is the Twin Blaster. Can we solo him? We do have a level advantage, so that is good. Does he see us? Maybe. Not sure. He should be able to see us now on the minimap. But he's not reacting to us, so that's good for us. Can we get him? Yes, yes, we're doing some damage. Let's go with him. Oh my god, he got away. See, I feel like I should use my ultimate, the Cole, then follow up by my ambush ability. Because I can't close the gap. Since there is a channel time that enemy players do have time to actually escape my ultimate. But once I actually root them, I have to get close to them. And it doesn't root them for too long. And getting close to them is kind of hard once your ambush ability is down. What's it cool? I'm talking a lot of stats for my first or my second game playing this character. So that's very interesting. I want to back off since there's two plays here. I'm guessing a third will appear from anywhere. Since there's a... the fifth player is missing at this very moment. Can we get this half star? The enemy team has already got it, so we're going to destroy it and claim it as our own. I see Khaimera, Twin Blaster in the right off lane. I'm going to take this, but once I take this, it could lead to something bad, honestly. So I want to be careful. I'm hoping they're not hearing this amazing pounce, not pounce, the amazing damage that we're doing at this very moment on this structure or harvester. Can we destroy it? Now they know we destroyed it. Hopefully they don't come here. Can we leave? Yes, we can. So that's good for us. Okay, we're going to recall now. Since we do have level 9, we just upgraded our ability, which is ultimate. And we have unspent points 7, so we have to use that up. We can get a strike upgrade. Now we got the wing cover fully done, so that's perfect for us. Followed up by... I'm thinking vision will be good. Problem is, I don't want mana and health. Not this very moment. Blood of Agora looks pretty nice. Let's get that. And I'm guessing it's 3-point upgrades. Yeah, magic strikes. Nice. But we can't get them now, unfortunately. So when you get some more half-star or CXP, then we'll be able to do so. So let's explain his other ability, which is pretty much his alternate ability, and that is called Ambush. Khaimera leaps to a target enemy hero, briefly stunning that hero and dealing 85 physical damage in an AoE effect. And that is some crazy stuff. And I'm thinking we should go to the left-hand side and skip. We're going to skip this camp. Of this buff cap, and we're trying to kill the enemy player that was on the left-hand side. Hopefully, we can catch him, but I'm guessing he really knows. Yeah, he does. There must be a ward somewhere. He just pay attention to the map, most likely. One of those. That's so cool for us. I'm loving the wards. There's so many wards on the map at this current moment, so I don't have to actually buy a key with wards. I mean, not a key with wards. I'd have to buy... a ward item, but I can most likely buy a key item instead. So we have total control over all the harvesters on the map. Okay, we're going to try and go to this right off lane. Let's kill this Twin Blaster. He only has one mobility type of thing that he can use within his kit, which is kind of a leap. And we need to stop him from doing that. But they're already reacting so quickly. Everyone was playing so safe. But once someone commits to something, everyone gets punished. I've noticed that. Enemy Khaimera is here, but we got my team still play here as well. We can't do anything to him yet, unfortunately. I think we're just going to get this Y camp. I prefer to just get this Y camp and then we just leave. They're waiting for us. They're just overlooking the scenario or the situation that is occurring right now. So we need to back off. It's not in our favor, even though we got deck on the offlane just ready. But I don't want to engage that. Not yet. Especially with only a blue orb. Because it only gives me CDR. That's the most beneficial part of it in a fight. But the mana regen is also useful as well. But if I'm going to fight someone, I'd rather have the red orb with me. Which is a major boost. Due to the movement speed increase you get and also the damage. We're going towards this. How else to get the CXP out of that? And most likely do another white camp and then maybe rotate to another lane. There's a fight going on right there. We might go there. Oh my god, guys, they're getting chewed, they're getting chewed. If we can get there in time, I'll demolish them. Again, they're getting chased, yeah? They're getting chased, and there's also another player that appeared out of nowhere, and that is the Twin Blaster. Oh my god, guys. Can we do this? Can we save our team? There we go. Use the ult and root the enemy. What? He didn't get rooted. Doesn't matter, though. He's dead. There's no way out of this. Accept your fate, mate. Oh my god, that actually rhymed, but it's cool. That's cool. Oh, the FPS drop. It's mad. It is actually mad. We killed one of their players. We can actually punish, but we don't have many wards around this section of the map because it's pretty deep into the actual territory. So we need to be careful because if they do pop out of anywhere, they could kill us. But we get to see the enemy Gideon on the left-hand side. Their Khaimera is dead since we just killed him not long ago. Enemy players most likely coming back from base. As you see, we see the Grux doing so. Dodged. Okay, we didn't dodge that. Oh my god, how much damage, man? No, 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 no. Now we're dead. We're dead. We're dead. The other way getting. Oh no, the Dekka died too. Oh my god, I thought she'd be able to escape. It's actually so hard to escape this character. Like, he has amazing abilities, but it's all in. Like, he can't just go halfway and then back off. It's just hard to back off, you get me? Because of the ambush ability, which makes you want to pounce towards them and just doing crazy damage. It's very interesting the way this kit works. And also, I can't wait to see him pricing how they'll play it. Because I'm thinking of so many combos of this character, and also decks, and certain strategies and guides you can create this character, making bloody OP on this map. The enemy Grux is there. Oh, he used his ultimate, but it got cancelled by the enemy Grux's ultimate. Oh my god, guys. That isn't too great. But he expected it. The enemy Grux expected that to happen. But see, it's also expected when he's got the Master Skin. He understands nearly every aspect or majority of the elements of that character due to the time he's played with it and the experience he's had. The one reason why I'm not going down there, I think the fight will end before I even get there. I just don't feel like it's one of those long fights. Because I feel like they will kill Grux, or Grux will get away. Okay, that didn't really happen. Can they back off? Because I know the enemy Khaimera is here, I don't want to react to that. Because I know she's going to push the offlane, and then we can just go defend that with this red orb. And most likely even kill her if we want to. Since she will have a hard time actually disengaging if she gets caught. Let's clear these minions. We're doing good damage at the moment. Can we get this half on the right side? No, we can't. We're going to destroy this and pick it up. Since we need it. Because CXP in the early game or mid-game section of the game is obviously very important. Because towards late game stages, majority of the time, you have 60 card points or card points to use for your deck. And it will make you crazy good. But if you can get that even earlier, you obviously will do more damage and be more beneficial to your team. So controlling harvesters will help the whole team. That's what you want. Okay, two things could happen right now. They could be getting a team objective, resetting, or a third thing coming for me. I'm hoping something coming for me, but... No, they're not ganking. Too cool. Where's the enemy get in? He's in the mid lane. That's all we got. Enemy Grux is on the left-hand side. Twin Blast on the right. Can we expect anything to happen? I'm not 100% sure, but we saw the Gideon disappear, which means that a team play or they're going to try and kill my team members in the left-hand side. So hopefully we can get down there in time and save the day. We're going to be Superman, boys. Put a point into our spin regeneration. Gideon went from the behind. Oh my god, guys. This isn't great. Can we shut him down, though? Oh, so my stun doesn't work? Wait, what? That does not make sense. That 100% doesn't make sense. My stun. How does that not work? We just saw, we just witnessed not long ago, the enemy Grux use his ultimate, which has a 0.5 second stun, to cancel the enemy Gideon's ultimate. Yes, that's what I saw. I'm pretty sure I saw that. And then we try to go for the exact same thing, but it doesn't work. Is it... Wait, I'm confused as hell. Is it the first tick of Gideon's ultimate you can cancel, but then the rest is pretty much immune to it, immune to crowd control? Is that what happens? Because I'm pretty sure there has to be something I'm missing. Because I've seen Grux, I've played Grux, and you can cancel Gideon's ultimate like that. And this character has a stun on his ambush ability, which is his alternate ability. As you can see, it says briefly stunning the enemy somewhere. Where is it? Yeah, briefly stunning that hero that I've done the ability on. In that case, it was the Gideon. I'm 100% sure I hit the Gideon, but it did not cancel it at all. That's sad, man. Maybe it's just a weird interaction that just occurred once. Hopefully it doesn't occur again. Unless it's a part of Grux's kin that I don't understand completely, I'm confirming with that stun. Or relating to that stun. Let's get this blue orb and let's get into the mid lane. Damn, man, that Twin Blaster. Took it out so quickly. What has he got? Oh, he's got 3 kills already. And his build's kind of decent. He's just got a lot of damage. Dang. Oh, water's OP, man. Oh. Get dehydrated, keep a bottle of water and G Fuel on the side. Perfect combo. Where is this? The enemy team just disappeared completely. And currently, we only have a couple of wards on the map. I'm thinking about buying a ward item. Just so we have some vision control. So I don't want to get demolished from, like, random points of the map. When I try to punish them. Or commit to some certain play. There's a ward up here. Or somewhere. I just can't see it. I'm lost, man. Stuff the wards. Can't get them anyway. They're just too high up majority of the time. Especially when you've got melee attacks, just doesn't help. Can't reach it, then it doesn't exist to me. We can do a split push on both lanes. Okay, we're gonna have a problem. Oh my god, man. Where's the ultimate? Oh my god. Did I panic and just activate my ultimate ability? I honestly think I did. Oh my god, is there a tank in this build? So I'm using a starter deck. The only tank item is this. Followed up by the Lord's Ward. Which, why not? Let's go for the Lord's Ward. Because I'm lordy, you know how it works. They made this item just for me, and we're going to get that. Oh my god. This has got cooldown. Cooldown's nice. Mana, I really don't care since I'm able to manage that quite well. Cooldown reduction and health is the most important part, followed up by the wards active that you get on that actual item. I'm trying to think what to do. Because I want to get structures. We obviously want to push to increase some type of distraction and also pressure on the map. But I obviously still want to get the team objectives done as well. Which are like harvesters control, vision control, and also actually getting that prime orb. Since that is one OP thing if we can actually get it. Especially if you can get it for the whole team by putting it into this destination. Oh my good guys. It's too late to think about these things. Too many stats. It's blowing my mind, mate. Pulling off like some type of Britain accent. And also saying Aussie words. Perfect combo. Let's clear this. Dekka needs to back off. Don't get caught, mate. Don't get caught. I think we need to get over there. Just as backup. Let's activate these pots and let's go help our team. They have no clue. Oh, what? Okay, yeah. Yeah, that is so exist. Create a put a ward, put a ward, put a ward. Three. Trouble mode. Yes, we can get away. We can get away. Sadly, the Dekka got caught. I could not stop that. The one thing I tried to do, which was a complete fail, was use my ultimate as the starting engage or pretty much way to stop the enemies from catching up to us. But then I just got completely wrecked by the enemy Khaimera because he used his ambush ability which stunned and cancelled my ultimate. As I expected when I did the exact same thing to the enemy player getting, but obviously that doesn't work against him. It wasn't going to work at all. Oh my god, guys. So sad. It's actually so sad. I feel like this character needs early gaming damage followed up by attack speed, then followed up by some type of tank-ish items. So I don't want to build crit on this guy. I want to be able to sustain as much as possible and be a constant nuisance to the enemy backline. Unfortunately, within this starter deck, it does not provide that, so I have to make my own deck with those items and cards. And hopefully the build actually works out pretty well. I'll test it later on in the next coming days. If it does, most likely expect a video on this channel. 100%. Let's put a point into our spirit regeneration. Hopefully that increases the health regen that we get from each hit. Or the stack that we get from each hit. So I can't actually see the stats for him. And I like to know all my stats when playing a character. Since it's very beneficial to what points you put into a certain ability. And I forget how hard it is to talk and play. Constantly. Every day. Especially with this game. So many things are happening all at once. Especially with this new update. Let's go in. Followed up by ultimate. That does not count. Oh my god. That's ridiculous, man. Can't I cancel his ultimate with my ultimate? Since it's a root. Is that a stun as well? This is just a root. It's just a root. Okay. Dang. I don't know why, but there's like little interactions that are not occurring when I'm playing as a character. Like I go for it, but it doesn't work out. Get away from that. Oh, what? That still got me. Nah, like a cool lag. I was so out of that. That saved us. Thank God that saved us. Okay, he's going for the ultimate. Can we take it? We need to take it. Oh my god. Do some damage. Pounce. No, we're too out of range. Oh, you stuff you, man. There's no way. There's actually no way. I know I'm lagging, yeah? That's understandable, but I feel like half the time I'm out of that range. He cannot pull me and then somehow pulls me. He's making the plays. Honestly, he is making the plays. Dang. That put us behind. We have 33 CXP. Yeah, it's good. Level 12. But the problem is, look at the enemy Grox. 36 CXP. Which, oh no, not CXP. 36 card points that he can use. Followed up by his level 15. Oh my god, guys. Three levels ahead. That punishment. There we go, guys. We're having a little bit of trouble. Hopefully, when we get towards the late game stages, we can actually do some more damage and be more of a nuisance to the enemy team. Because right now, it's going in their favor quite a lot. I'm just hoping this stun actually works. Because I'm seeing other people landing a perfect stun on an ult and then cancelling it. Then I do the exact same thing and it's not working. God damn it. This is interesting though. Look at the way the character moves. Always just makes it go crazy. Looks so beast-like. Get it? Because, you know, it's a beast pun. Never mind, guys. Oh my god, guys. I'm hoping there's an actual skin that gives him like a deer. Puts a deer on his back. That'd be crazy. Because we've seen the white tiger skin. That is gorgeous. I can't say anything bad about that. It's one amazing T1 skin. Is that an enemy player? Enemy Grox is here, so we need to watch out. Twin Blast. Dodge that. Twin Blast, come back before he pulls you in. We're making plays. We're making plays, boys. Let's go in. Let's go in. Pulled up by ultimate. There we go. Can Gideon... Wait, is that... That was enemy Gideon. Stun. There you go. Destroyed. Can we catch up? Unfortunately, can't catch up. Wait, whose ultimate was that? Okay, I don't know if that was our ultimate. The Gideon's ultimate, sorry. Because I saw it still occurring, but I couldn't see Gideon. Unless it was just floating there. That fail pull. Oh, we're dead. We dead, boys. We dead. We dead. Oh, my God. Okay. Okay, I'm seeing how this guy's playing. They're playing tough, like. It's kind of getting annoying. But we're cool with it. We're cool. Oh, no, this is sad. Is this a 4v5? This is a 4v5, man. I feel guilty. Even if I'm losing right now, and then we'll most likely end up winning later, due to the fact that we have 5 players. And that's why they have level 15s and level 14s. They just scaled better. Since they have less players in one lane, majority of the time. But obviously their team fighting was pretty good as well, I can't say anything bad about that. They did pretty well. And they are doing pretty well still. It would be kind of sad if I lose a 4v5. Especially when they have the 4 minute plays on their team. I do not feel guilty if I win or not. It's a fun time all the time on Paragon. That is guaranteed. It's a 4v5. Oh my god. I think that's the only reason why they're so ahead with CXP and also level. More level than in CXP. But good work on this Grox, man. He's keeping the team in the game. Keeping his team in the game. Thought I stuffed up saying that. That's so cool. Let's collect this. Let's go to this blue orb and hopefully pick that up without any enemy Groxes appearing out of nowhere. We see him there. Oh, I want to go kill him. He's out of mana. Thing is, he might disengage because he doesn't know where we're all at. Should I go from behind? I'm going to push this. He's going for the objective. You're gone, man. You're gone. Guaranteed death. No. Yes, there we go. Did we get it? Please set. Yes, there we go, man. Oh my god. Put a point into our ultimate. I don't know why that felt so satisfying. After all the times he got me back with his pull-in, I get that kill on him. Perfect. So the little combos you can do on this character are pretty much going in engaging with your ambush ability, which I'm not sure what the cooldown is on it. Hopefully we can see it. No, we can't see the cooldown, sadly. If the cooldown's pretty low, you pretty much engage with your ambush ability, followed up by your unleash ability, and you'll be stacking your spirit regeneration, hopefully trying to engage the backline, because you'll be able to shred them quite easily, since if you're building damage, it's... Oh my god. No. See, that cancelled that time. That cancelled. I respect that. Wow, he's doing more damage. He's doing a lot more damage. We need to back off. Recall. Not recall. Go into travel mode, sorry. Please disengage. Don't engage that. Do not engage that. At all. I got caught, but thank god this still plays a beast. This is one difficult time. Honestly. I know, I feel like there's a learning curve to this character. I play junglers. I enjoy junglers. Oh my god, that range! So dirty. I honestly thought he was out of range. What I like to do when I play a game, especially when it comes to MOBAs, and even a game like this, I always keep my distance, depending on the attack range. and then I change it depending if they have mobility or some type of thing. So I had a good enough distance then. For some reason, that shot landed on me. I don't know if his attack... I don't play a lot of Twin Blaster, so if his attack range does scale during stages of the game, kind of sad. Oh no, this is not going to end up too well. Okay. Okay. I see you. I see you. No, he got stuck. He got stuck on the terrain. No. Oh my god, guys. Okay. Okay. Back to the combo, something more brighter. So pretty much once you're gaining spirit regeneration stacks through your unleash ability and ready to use your ambush ability, Mesorica, you can follow that by the Call Ultimate, which will root and pretty much slow down the enemies on the enemy team by a certain percentage, which is quite useful. Then you can follow up by another ambush if it comes back on cooldown, pretty much do as much damage as possible and continue that combo, obviously without your ultimate, since your ultimate will have the highest cooldown on that actual thing. So it's interesting, but I still have to still learn him. And see how he interacts with other characters. That's the major fact, or the major elements that I need to understand. Yes, yeah, everyone's calling him out, but he even called himself out. Okay, right now, the game isn't in our favor that much. But we have 5 players, so anything can actually happen. Thing is, we need to group perfectly, and I need to actually stop getting caught. Because I always play ballsy, and I can't do it with this character, since his disengage isn't that great, but his all-in is amazing. We're going to try to go over there where the fight is occurring next to our half-star. There's 2 enemy players, and they will get punished for this, for fully committing, hopefully. That stun, followed up by the kill, and let's try to kill this enemy Grux, but he's already in trouble mode, so I'm guessing he's going to escape. There's no way we're going to catch up to him. If we do, this will be amazing, because right now he's going the long way. Which gives us a chance. There we go. There we go. Wrecked. Wrecked, mate. There was no escape for you, man. I knew. You know why? I was paying attention to the minimaps. Say if we're going from that point to that point, from A to B, that what we just did there, and he's going from the side. He's going the long way. He's taking a long time to get to the destination that he needed to be at, or to escape at. And obviously, that wasn't great for him. Our team is doing pretty well on the other side, having a fight there. And it looks like it's in our favor. That fight. Come on, team, let's finish off that last player. That is the so-called official ace, since there's only 4 players on the team, sadly. But as expected, towards late game stages, this comp that we're running right now is disgusting. Disgustingly good, though. Just the damage output is crazy. The crowd control, the team plays, it's just flashy as hell, and that's what we wanted. And I think it's pretty good. I was just hoping we reverse the 5 players, that's all. Because it started off as a 5v5, but then it just disappeared. I think the enemy player just got on tilt. After getting 3 deaths as Gadget, he just went on tilt. That's sad. But so cool. I want to see how high we get this stacking. Is it capped? Because I'm not sure if it's capped. Right now we got 23, 24, 25, and 20, nearly 27. I don't think it's capped, honestly. It just depends on how many hits you can actually do on an enemy hero without actually cancelling it. The stacking time. Oh, I love the way his axes change. Activate the unleash ability and then he changes color. Because it's like his red glow on it. Red-orange glow. Looks beast-like. Nice, nice. We can just split push, honestly. If they do decide to destroy one of the split pushes, or a lane with split pushes, the other lane can just punish for it. So much they can do. Due to the fact they have one less player. Problem is, see if they had less players, yeah? They scaled a lot more better. Which is, oh my god, no, 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 no! Come, we're coming, boys, we're coming. Can we kill him? Can we kill him? There we go. Good work, good work. Can we finish off the enemy Khaimera as well? He might kill me. He does kill me. Wow, man. The one thing I'm forgetting to use is my wards, honestly. I have my kit, but I just keep forgetting to press 3. So I just press 2 constantly. So I'm used to putting wards on 2 and every member I play. They're going to kill that Grux. There we go. Good work, team, for killing that Grux. And most likely we'll be able to get the mid tower, and then followed up by the inhibitor, since they are on a large respawn time. Hopefully. The steel blade does survive. It's only Khaimera, the enemy Khaimera, in that mid lane at these very moments. They could siege it. It's not like he can do it all in and survive. Hopefully not. Oh my god, guys. I can't wait to make decks for this guy. There's so many things you can do. Like, is that great? Like, today we're playing in the jungle. We play solo jungle. Obviously, due to the meta changes that occurred in this patch, solo jungle is the best jungle. And it's powerful. Don't get me wrong, his ganks are truly amazing, especially in the early game, due to the fact that he has a stun, a root, and all these other interesting stuff within his kit. But I feel like the one thing I hate about him is that he can't disengage well. If you don't time your disengages, you're going to get caught, you're going to get wrecked completely. And obviously, you don't want that to happen to you every single game, because that would just create a tilt occurrence. And obviously, that's not great. That is not great. Being tilted in this game is just devastating. But it's all cool. We're slowly understanding this character. Right now, we've got 5 kills, 8 deaths, unfortunately, 6 assists, and 88 minion kills. And we've got CXP, quite a lot of CXP. And we've got 45 card points to use. And we're level 14 at this very moment. Let's get this red buff. We should just get the Prime Orb. There's no way they can stop us from getting it. Unless they invade perfectly, like the perfect time. I want to ping it, and then we can just push. Just the fact that the Prime cards will activate if we have all Prime on every team member. And while they're pushing, the minions do get stronger as well. So I'm thinking that is a good chance, or a good thing to do at this very moment. Since they can't prevent it. There's no way. The only thing they can do is keep on pushing a certain lane, I'm guessing right lane in this case, if there's someone there. I thought I saw someone in the right lane. That's so cool. Just take the all prime. Trust me, boys. 3 of us all prime it. Well, I can just... Can we do this solo? I'm very interested. I think we can. It looks so easy. Put a wall there just in case someone comes from the off lanes. Just warp the whole place around it for safety reasons, and that is all. So when it comes to actually doing a monster camp, the only ability I can use, or the things I can actually use on the camp, are my hack or melee strikes, followed up by my unleash ability, which are also melee strikes, and then my pounce ability ambush or my spirit regeneration doesn't do too much damage wise, because I can't use my ambush, and then followed up by my other ability, which is spirit regeneration, which is obviously a passive. Oh, we could do that. We could do that, but do we have to? Can we just dunk it straight away? As Khaimera? The first dunk ever. I'm thinking about it. Can we do it? They're all gonna be in the shadow pad. Watch. Yeah, boys, they're not here. They're chasing us, though. Doesn't matter. Prime Orb has been activated. Let's punish! They know what's up. They're terrified, boys. There we go. We got a kill on that guy. Now I'm going to push up. Pounce. Followed up by a root. There we go. Oh my god, guys. We need back off. Oh my god. No. Stack. You get movement speed on your Q? Oh my god. This twin blaster hunting me down. Come on, all my team members. Come. Help our team. Because they're coming back from a spawn. Because we did engage really quickly when we had two members down already. But they have no clue that Steel and Twin Blast are here to save the day. Deca might die for this. Hoping she doesn't. That Stasis Bomb. Stunning the Grux perfectly. And now, because the Grux is pretty much out of mana, there's no escape for him. And there we go. Another ace or another cleanup. That worked out pretty well. Always forget, does the Prime Orb still activate? Or your Prime card still be activated once you put it into the destination? Obviously, that's when it activates. But once you die, does it still activate? I never check. And I don't know if there's a way to check if it's activated or not without checking your damage. Let's check the shop, see if it says there. Nah. Yeah, it doesn't occur. It drops like a normal orb does Because usually if you pick up an orb, it comes up on your right lower screen as that you've got the orb with the timer. In this case, since we died with the prime orb being activated or the prime cards being activated, it doesn't say we have that anymore, sadly. We've got 7 points, so we're going to use that wisely. We're going to get some more health and get that card item done, followed up by another item. I'm feeling a little bit of crit chance. Anyone else, man? Anyone else? Crit chance looks pretty dirty at the moment. Let's do crit chance. Should be very interesting. Since crit chance isn't as great as before within the older patches of the game, since they did nerf it quite a bit, but now, I think it could be kind of interesting on this character. Especially if you've got damage from early game and attack speed from early game, why not build some crit chance? You know? We're gonna test it out. But I'm not sure if it's that strong. Because crit's all good and all, but I can just build more attack damage and more attack speed. And they'd be more beast-like. Because I'm able to sustain more in the fight. Because the hardest thing to do is get your health regen to a high amount while in a fight. Pick up that red orb. Dodge that. A team member Grux is there. We're dodging these. We're going... What? No, 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 no. No, 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 no. Come on, Grux. Get in. Come here. Oh my god, just the timing. The timing was so bad. I got caught. Oh my god. The all-ins, man. I can't determine his range, the Twin Blaster range. Like, I know I shouldn't be there, but I'm just trying to be intimidating and pretty much do a certain distraction. Okay, I need to tell his team, our boys, we need to actually group so I stop getting caught. Because that's what's happening right now. Because I want to go engage in a fight. Yeah, or pretty much be intimidating to the enemy team. But once I get caught, I have no way of getting out. And it's actually destroying me. Like, if I play Kaleri, Grux, I have my dash, which I can use on anything or anywhere. And with Kaleri, I have my backflip, I have my invisibility, Shadow Walk, I have all these other things I can use on them. Which makes them godlike characters for engaging and escaping. For this character, he's a godlike character, don't get me wrong. The master of the jungle, Khaimera, 100% he's a god. But the thing is, you can only all engage. I've been ranting about this quite a lot, and the lag is getting to me. Because recently, the OS servers were back on during a beta weekend, a free beta weekend for players that got invited to actually play. But there was no announcement of it. Like, I heard it through friends telling me that OS servers were there, but there was no one playing because there was no information about them being back online. Kind of sad. Let's go back. We got 4 points. As I jumped out, we just upgraded. CXP wise. Let's get that. Another wound. Well, man. One hard game. I want to say that. Surprisingly, from a 4v5, I'm getting destroyed still. Dang. This Gideon carry though. 60 card points already. Dirty, dirty. I'm gonna love it. He's the first player to get 60 card points. Bloody amazing. Deserves that. I'm thinking about getting this Black Orb or giving it to Twin Blast. Come on, Twin Blast. Come down. We'll give it towards to him and hopefully he picks it up. And we're able to push. This is gonna work out too well. Enemy team, please don't have any wards here. Because now they're all disappeared completely. Okay, they're mid lane. Pick that all up. Pick it up. Good work. Okay, we're going to go towards mid lane. We need to defend this. Dekka's putting off some plays. Was that a 1v4? Or 1v3? I'm thinking that's a 1v3. But that's still dirty, man. Take that, man. Take that. You're not getting out of this. There's no way out of this. How long is that route, man? I actually want to know how long that route is. Oh my god. I can't reach him. Kill his Grux as well. Body blocking. There we go. We got that kill as well. I think it was out of range. Somehow we got that kill. I have no clue how, We don't have the red orb or any type of thing to pretty much do any damage after it, but that was kind of interesting. There's some points within this gameplay when I use my Unleash ability, I get this increased movement speed. And I don't know why. I don't know if it's maybe this, maybe we'll steal. You know, when Steel places that massive fence, you also get some movement speed out of it and a shield. I think maybe it was that. And I just randomly walked into it and I didn't notice. Quite interesting, that's for sure. Let's get some health regen back since we need his health. Before the enemy team does respawn and do some damage. But most likely we can take down all three inhibs before they actually respawn. It's sad that this is end up being a 4v5. Especially this time. They did put up a fight, I'm gonna give them that. And this character is gonna be quite interesting character to get good with and understand during the times we play this character. Push that minion wave and we'll take this right here. Still, yep, go. Good whiff. Should be able to get this quite easily. Especially when still is tanking it and we're doing all this damage. There we go. Quite super easy. And now, keep pushing. I think the team has given up. Have they? No, they haven't. Oh my god. Oh my god, that Twin Blast! What does he have? I want to check his actual deck. Okay. Somehow, without any crit chance, he's doing amazing damage. Still doing amazing damage. I honestly think this character needs armor. Physical armor plus some tank. And depending on the situation, some even, energy armor. Because that would work with him quite a lot. Energy armor. Followed up by... But oh my god, there's too many items. Too many different items. Thing is, when you make a build, you always want to dedicate to one thing only. Yeah, lol. Wait. All prime again. Ha. All prime is the only way we're going to push and win, honestly. At this rate. Since they do so much damage. Honestly, I'm shocked. I am actually shocked about how much damage these guys are doing. I feel sorry for them. But they're doing damage still, so that's making them quite intense matchup, if that makes any sense. Yeah, he's right. There's nothing they can do, though. The enemy team. They can't stop it. There's no way preventing us from pushing at all at this rate. Unless they win a 4v5, it's a clean cleanup, and they just push constantly and pretty much tank the inhibs and then push to... Our core. Because they could do that. It's bound to happen as well, to be honest. I expect it. If we lose one fight, they will punish. Because why not? If you have the chance to win, obviously you'll take it. There's no stopping that. I don't think I'll be able to use all 60 card points within this build. Due to the fact of these upgrades. See, there's so many things I don't like about these the decks. How they pretty much put you in a position when you can only use one deck during a whole game. Especially when the game goes for 50 minutes. Not a big fan of that. I want to obviously change and counter build depending on the scenario. And when you make a deck, there's not much room for that. Especially when you have like a certain amount of cards that you can use in a deck. Which is 40 cards. Unless they change them. So it makes it kind of hard. But it's all cool. Hopefully we can explain that sometime in the future. Another video, pretty much the benefits and the pretty much pros and cons of that, if they do change that. We got the prime over at this very moment. I'm just pushing mid wave, so we get the super minions pushing as well, because we're stacking them up as we go. Right now we got 4 super minions, and that's pretty dirty. And once this prime orb has been activated, these minions will get a buff as well. The enemy team is trying to put up a fight, so we're going to go from the back line and destroy them, since our all-in is just disgusting. Not too disgusting, though. Not too disgusting. Oh, my God. No. Not this again. I'm actually worrying right now. We've got the Prime Orb activated, yes? I understand that. But what will happen if the enemy team decides to go in groups and pick us off one by one? Because out of nowhere, the enemy team just turned around completely and destroyed me. I didn't think they have any vision on me. But the most likely was a mini wave coming towards me. And they saw me like that. So they got good map awareness, that's for sure. Outplaying a 4v5 team. Kind of sad. Now look at these card reworks. Like the actual images for them. I haven't noticed them quite a lot, but once I notice them, they look beast-like. Source reward. Oh my god, guys. It's crazy good. Before, they just used to be blue cards. Or red color cards, depending on what affinity it was. But now we've actually got images. Looks so beast-like. Just gives it more character. Gideon does use his ultimate, and he's bringing everyone to the black hole, followed by steals ultimate and gets a kill on the enemy Twin Blaster. Then we also get another kill on enemy Grux due to the Twin Blaster destroying him. And now we got Steel, Gideon, and Twin Blast pushing the core. They end up killing the Khaimera as well. The core is taking amazing damage, and that is GG, boys. Sadly, against a 4v5 team. Kind of sad, but we still win. That is all that matters. Unfortunately, I'm hoping they fix this. Like, if they notice a 4v5 from the start, that's not there and it's not connected, obviously disconnect that. If that doesn't occur, this will end up occurring, which means the 5-play team will end up winning the majority of the time due to the fact that these games go for so long, and late game scaling is always in favor with the team that has 5 players, because they'll be able to do a lot more. So we had an intense game, I'm going to say that, due to the fact that the all-in is amazing on this character, but the disengage, which is something I'm not used to on this character, is very weak. And I don't like characters like that too often. But this character provides a new outlook to the jungle, pretty much with this all-in and pretty much this amazing kit. But I just have to get used to it. So I'm going to play a couple more games and get more of understanding before we make builds or guides on this character. And so mates, if you enjoy this video, show your support, smash that like button. Let's rate 30 likes on this video. And if you guys want to see more Paragon gaming content on my channel, all you have to do is share this with your friends and hit the subscribe button to become a mate today. And that is all for this video. Oh, it's time to go, but don't you worry. Back very soon. Hey, Tats boys, presenting nothing yet. Wow, man, this one crazy character, but that was one intense match as well. Saying that it feels right.